front of my house in L.A. And the way we met was my radio show, The Wake Up Show, used to come on right after his radio show, Ruthless Radio in Los Angeles. He was on from 6 to 9. We were on from 9 to 12. So in that transition of the radio stations, I mean, the radio shows, I would always talk with Easy. And one of the things he used to always tell me was, he used to always say, yo, Sway, man, you got to play my group, man. You're going to like these boys, man. They from the Midwest. And I was like, okay, Easy, because Easy was a salesman, the same way that Diddy is today, the same way that Dame Dash is today, the same way that DJ Khaled is. That's how Easy was. He was a salesman. And I was like, well, what's the name of this group? Man, you know, they call Bone Thugs and Harmony, man. Can you play this on your show? And I remember the first time, we weren't necessarily into it, but we never really listened to it. And that wasn't kind of what we played in our show. But we ended up playing, I think it was first of the month, by Bone Thugs and Harmony. We played it before anybody else would. People wouldn't give him a chance because at that time, he had broken off from Dre and Ice Cube had cut out, so people didn't really think that Eazy-E still had it. And for Bone Thugs and Harmony to become as big as they were at that time, and I dare to say that they outsold N.W.A. in a lot of ways at one point, that really, I think, was one of the highlights of Eazy-E's career. I remember him coming to my house once and saying, man, take a drive with me, man. And he had a car, it was like a Navigator or something. It was an SUV that at that time was like, yo, man, what is this, a rocket ship? You know, and we went riding in his car and he started playing me a lot of music from his record label. But he was always by himself, you know. I always noticed that when he traveled, that he didn't have bodyguards. He didn't have a lot of people around him. And he used to love to sit up and talk. And I remember we sat up and talked for a long time that night. And, you know, when you talk to him, he was the most genuine person you would want to know. He was funny. And then I remember one time he was digging in his glove department to give me a copy of a CD. And this dude, you know, scrambling through that glove department. I was like, well, what are you looking for? He's like, the CD. He started pulling stuff out. He pulled a box out. He pulled a napkin out, maybe. And then he pulled out a gun that was so big, man. And I hadn't seen one like that before. I jumped. I'm like, oh, man. Then it reminded you that this dude really did come from the street. And he said, never mind her, always keep her next to me, you never know. You know, and it was just show the dichotomy of that dude's personality that I'll never forget. So he's truly missing.